Hello friends, today we will see the problem on helix on cylinder. So for that purpose, the problem statement is draw cylindrical helix of diameter 60 mm and pitch 70 mm for 1/2 convolution of angle of helix. So this will be the problem statement. So as for problem statement, we have to draw a cylinder. So for that D of 60 mm. And they have given the pitch of 70 mm. So as for this, I will take a dimension of that diameter. So for that purpose, I have to take a radius of 30 mm in compass. And I have to draw a circle in top view. So here I have completed a circle. So I have completed circle of 60 mm diameter. Then as per the procedure, we have to divide this circle into 8 parts. So first I will draw horizontal line, then next vertical, then that circle we get divided into 4 parts. Next I will bisect that one sector. So here I will divide that circle into 8 parts. So this will be the 45 degree, and right side also we have to take 45 degree. After joining this, we will bisect these sectors. And here we'll get the 8 parts of this circle. So here I will give naming to this circle. So this will be the P points. This will be 1 number, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, and last will be the 8. So these all 8 parts are done on that circle. So next step is we have to take projection in front view. So for that purpose, I have to take projection of these sides. So here I have taken the projection. So after taking the projection, if we will see the height of that cylinder. So here they have given the pitch of 70 mm, but they have not given the height of that cylinder. But here the pitch they have given the 70 mm, but for calculating the height, we have a formula. H is equal to N into P. N is the number of convolution. If we will see this problem, in that problem they have given the 1/2 convolution. 1/2 convolution means 1.5 into pitch they have given the 70. So here the mm. Okay. So here the height of that cylinder will be how much? The 105. So here I will draw a horizontal line, and height of this cylinder will be the 105. Okay. Okay, so as for procedure, I will take all projection of top view into a front view. So first I will take projection of 1 and 7 I will take into front view by joining that 1 and 2. So I have taken the projection of 1 and 2. Next I will take projection of 2 and 6. Next I will take projection of 3 and 5. Okay, then we have divided this circle into 8 parts. Similar way, we have to divide this axis height of this cylinder into 8 parts. But if we will see here, the one for one revolution we have divided into 8 parts, and next half revolution we have to divide that into 4 parts, because for one revolution we have divided 8, and for next half revolution that will be 8 divided by 2, so 4, 8 plus 4, that will be how much? 12 parts. So this vertical line you have to divide into 12 parts, because they have told that the one half convolution, the cylinder of helix is rotating by one half convolution. So we have started 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. So here that will be 9, here that will be 10, here that will be the 11, and this will be the 12. So our curve will be start from here, and this will be end here. Okay, after completing one half revolution. So for that purpose, I will take inclined line for dividing this vertical line. I will take inclined line, and I will divide this inclined line into 8 parts. So this will be 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, and 12. Okay. After that, we have to join this. Then we will get equal parts on that vertical 105 axis height. So now, as per the procedure, I will give naming. So here I will give P, this will be 1, this will be 2, this will be 3, this will be 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, and this will be the 12. So we are here, so we have divided this vertical height, and we have to take projection into a horizontal line. So here I have taken a projection into a horizontal line. Okay. So as for procedure, here we'll start point from here P, and here we'll see this cylinder is rotating. Cylinder is rotating in anti-clockwise direction. So first point is here. So we'll get intersection of vertical one number line and horizontal one line here. Here we'll get intersection of 2 and 2 here. Here we'll get intersection of third number line and third number horizontal line here. Here we'll get intersection of fourth number and fourth number here. So now we'll see here these 8 to 4 number points we can visualize into a front view, but after that fourth line, that points are not visualizing in front view. So these 4 to 5, 5 to 6, 6 to 7, 7 to 8, these all points will be get had. So here intersection of this fifth line and intersection of horizontal fifth line will be here. So here intersection of sixth and sixth vertical, here we'll get intersection of vertical seven number line and horizontal seven number line here. Intersection of eight number point, vertical and horizontal eight, will get here. Again this point will be come into picture. After that again this half revolution will be visualized, because this is coming into front view. Front mein dikh raha hai aapko. So here intersection of this 9 number line and 9 number horizontal will be here. Intersection of 10 and 10 will be here. Intersection of 11 and 11 number here. Intersection of 12 and 12 number is here. So likewise here we'll get all points. So here So as for procedure, I will try to draw. I will give naming to all these points. This will be the P1, this will be P2, this will be P3, this will be P4, this will be P5, this will be P6, this will be P7, this will be P8, this will be P9, this will be P10, and this will be P11, this will be the P12. So likewise, I have given naming P1, P2, P3, P4, P5, P6, P7. This will be the P8. This will be P9. This will be P10. This will be P11. And this will be the P12. Okay. So here we have given naming. And I will join these all points. So this 8 to 4 points will be look dark because this is in front view. So I will join. After P4, that points will be get hidden, so that we have to join by dotted lines because we are showing hidden lines by dotted lines. Again, this 8 to 12 will be look into a dark. So our that helix of that cylinder will be get completed in that way. So these type of questions always ask in university exam. If you have any doubt, you can put into comment and I will give answer for this question. So okay, thank you.